Check us out on Patreon, guys, where we're giving you the entire year now for $10.08. Over 100 videos worth of content for $10.08.
8 cents is just such a slap in the face.
Like 84 cents a month, I think is what it comes out to.
I haven't seen 84 cents in 15 years. I'm telling you. Ever since Penny Candy.
So check us out on Patreon, guys. Hope to see you there.
The entire year.
What's up, guys? Keeping the Women Who Rock Marathon going. I'm Ryan, my man George.
What's shit, guys? How you living out there, man? Shout out to the Free Thinkers. Yes.
Now, I have a disclosure I got to make real quick. Disclosure. Evanescence, I've heard before. I heard...
100%.
Yeah, you know, and I've heard that song, that what was the one from Daredevil?
This one, sir.
There we go, yep.
Yo, she really...
Dude, her voice is dope.
I know that people are probably tired of
it. How can you see into my
destruction.
Eyes?
Destruction. Destruction, man. So I'm glad that you played a little piece of that. So that's my full disclosure. So I am familiar with this band. Another disclosure. I thought Evanescence was the actual name of the lead singer. Actually, it's Amy Lee. So
shout
I learned
to,
that.
To Amy Lee.
Yeah.
What I didn't know was that Amy Lee is regarded as one of the greatest ever. I just thought that she was really dope.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, she's dope. And I remember hearing this song. And again, this is when I started to when I had my few bands in metal or rock or whatever you want to call it that I went to, like the Linkin Park and Korn. And, you know, you guys know those bands at this point. And I remember hearing this song and I was like, who is that?
Yep.
And I didn't even really give too many fucks about rock or anything like that at that juncture in my life, you know. But I knew that this was special. I knew that she was special. I was like, I don't know what that is. Or like, her voice was amazing, man.
Sang her ass off.
So we're both excited about this one.
Yes,
sir. We kind of know what we're getting into with Amy Lee and Evanescence, but we haven't heard too many songs from her. We went with Lithium because that seemed the most unfamiliar. I think we both, Ryan has heard Call Me.
Yeah.
When I'm sober.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And what was the other one that we heard?
That one.
Immortal for Me. I don't know if you've heard
Immortal. I don't think I've heard
I've
that.
Heard Immortal.
That one. Bring you back to life.
Yeah. Bring you back to life. And Immortal for Me, but she crushed Immortal as well. So I'm not sure if I've heard Lithium. We'll see when we play it. But that was a pretty decent request in the comment section. We got a lot of people, really, to be honest with you, that hit us behind the scenes for Lithium. And that's been a big request on YouTube for a while as well. So we went with Lithium. A little bit about Evanescence, though. And we're going to do a little bit on Amy Lee and Evanescence kind of separately here. It says Amy Lee is an American singer, songwriter, and pianist. She is the co-founder and lead vocalist of the rock band Evanescence.
Yeah.
Alongside her contributions with the band, Lee also participated in other musical projects, including Nightmare, We Visited, and Muppets, the Green Album from Walt Disney Records. Lee received the Songwriter Icon Award from the National Music Publishers Association in 2008. In 2012, she won Best Vocalist at the Revolver Golden Gods Awards and was also named Rock Goddess of the Year at the Loudwire Music Awards. She was awarded Best Film Score by the Moondance International Film Festival for Indigo Gray, The Passage, in 2015. Lee is also an American chairperson for the International Epilepsy Awareness Foundation Out of the Shadows.
That's cool. That's cool.
And she's from Riverside. Shout out to Riverside, Cali. It looks like Evanescence, man, that first album, which I believe Bring Me Back to Life was on, that came out in 2003. It said that album Fallen sold more than 17 million copies worldwide.
That's crazy.
And I remember that being out of here.
I remember that, too.
I remember that distinctly. Like, oh, this is big. And it helped the band win 2 Grammy Awards out of the 6 nominations. Says a year later, Evanescence released their first live album, Anywhere But Home, which sold another 1 million copies. In 2006, the band released their second studio album, The Open Door.
Which this is on. Lithium is on.
Yep. And that one sold 5 million copies. You know what I mean? So they are definitely commercially successful. And again, man, like I said, I just did not know that she was regarded the way she's regarded in terms of just her vocal ability as being one of the greatest, you know, female vocalists of all time. You know what I mean? So that's pretty amazing.
That's true.
And I'm happy because that makes sense.
And I'm glad that you bring that up because she needs to be in that conversation.
Her voice.
Seriously. She needs to be in that conversation.
So let's get into it, man. Continuing on with the Women Who Rock Marathon, Evanescence, Lithium, featuring the great Amy Lee. Back, but her voice is just, she's just gifted, dude. Like, I don't say that often. Dude. It's just a gift. You know, there's a lot of people that you can train to sing and hit notes and this and that, but it's just, I don't know, like the word ethereal comes to mind. Mm-hmm. Just transcendent comes to mind.
Crazy, dude.
It didn't take, even Ryan, like, it didn't take us long to be like, yeah, that's. It doesn't really take long when the talent is just so completely
mind-blowing,
yeah. Undeniable. It doesn't take long for you to be like, yeah, that's. It took her a couple notes.
Yep. You know? You're like, yeah, it's beautiful.
Wanna let it go.
Okay.
This is a perfect marriage so far. And I know we're only seconds into the shit.
That's what I love about this. The impact of this.
Yep. Playlist already for me. I can't speak for you, but playlist for me already. The way
I don't think I need to speak.
The way that
look at my face, bro. That's out of here.
I love the little a cappella start to that and the powerful riff that came in. That is the perfect marriage to me. If I could form a band, a metal rock, whatever you want to call it, band, that's what I would want. I would want a very strong vocalist that can sing their ass off, man or woman, but I think it works better for a woman in this particular scenario because Amy Lee is just transcendent in the way she can sing. Hard, powerful guitar riffs. It's just magical to me.
That is, man.
That's catnip for me.
It is magical. that's what her voice, no, seriously. Like, it is magical. The feeling that she gives you, man. Though.
Yeah, of course I do.
Let's start it back up.
Yeah, you don't have to.
Damn, man, we are kind of far though.
Yeah, we can go back to when the. Let's fuck it. Let's do it.
And the piano is amazing in this as well. She's playing the piano.
Don't make me sleep, no.
best.
I can say she can sing me out my drawers, though. I know that. Usually, like this guy.
It don't. No one has to sing me out of out of anything.
You know,
I tell you, you know,
it don't take much.
Yeah, it don't take that. Yeah. Again, though, you can always say that this is maybe not your style, but I don't think you can deny the skill that she has, man. It's just, it's beautiful. It's just beautiful, man. And this is one of those times, George, I really want to bring to light that, oh, because I've seen in the comments, like, Ryan just likes this, or he just likes that, you know, or George just likes this. This is a song that I don't think a lot of people would say, oh, this is going to be right up George and Ryan's alley. I don't think they would say that, you know? But the reason why it is because it's just great. It's just done at a very, very high level. Regardless of what kind of music you like or what you're biased to, this is the reason. This song, to me, embodies why we started the channel, man. Because we wanted to explore things outside of our wheelhouse because there's greatness in everything, in every 100%. Genre. There's greatness in everything, 100%. Man. And you wouldn't do that unless you push yourself to be a little bit more objective and a little bit more open when it comes to music, as opposed to just listening to the same shit because you like it. So this is a perfect example, and I really want to take the opportunity to say that, to bring that to the forefront, because she is bodying this, and this is playlist for me. We haven't even gotten through the whole fucking song. Yeah. And it's still playlist for me.
It's an amazing song. Amazing performance by her. Probably my favorite performance of the... marathon, and I'm just being honest.
Yes,
like this is having the most impact on me out of anything we've done, and we've had some bangers, man.
Yes,
shout out to everybody we've done, but this was this is pretty great. Let's get back to it.
And I don't say this often, guys, man, but I feel like this video, or excuse me, her voice, man, can really get you through a tough time. Mm-hmm. Because it sounds like, based on some of the lyrics here, it looks like she's in a toxic relationship that is probably not good for her, but she's like, fuck it, I'd rather be with you than be alone. So if I'm just destined to not be happy, but I love you that much, maybe. Maybe it's just you're so in love with this significant other, so to speak. But I could be wrong, but that's just kind of what I'm getting from the lyricism.
I didn't look at one lyric this time. which is crazy for him
to say. Yeah. But the bottom line, it goes to how great she sang it.
Yeah.
You know, it's so fucking powerful, man. And I think the guitar work and the musicianship kind of brings to life how powerful her voice is.
Yes.
And that typically doesn't happen when we do songs on this channel, guys. It's usually kind of one or the other. It's very rare that, for me, I'm speaking for me, not necessarily George, but for me, it's rare to see a marriage of those two things done at such a high level that I absolutely love. This is really not a song that typically I would like so much, you know? So that's why I love that we do this, man. We constantly push ourselves because this is phenomenal. Like I said, this is one of the best songs I've ever heard in my life, dude.
Dude, it's a great song, but I didn't really have to push myself. This isn't me having to like think and be like, okay, well, this is the time period, yep, and you know, it was the 70s and it was the 80s. No, I can hear this if I'm 80 years old, and I know metalheads is gonna understand this. You know, the purist and all that. Like, you can hear this. I don't care what era you're in. You know that her voice is unbelievable. And it's distinctive and it's powerful.
Yep.
And I'm not even just... from a feeling standpoint, it's unbelievable. From a technical standpoint, she's incredible. Yep. I'm sure that we can watch one of those vocal coach channels and they'll tell you, if they haven't already, you know, I'm sure they'll tell you that her voice is, from a technical standpoint, brilliant.
Yeah.
I mean, but the feeling, the emotion she pulls out, of not only just herself and the music, but the emotion she pulls out of you, because I got goosebumps.
Yes, dude.
And she just transported me somewhere else. That was really, really well done, man.
Dude, incredible. I wonder if she's done any Disney movies, man, because I really feel, because I made a joke that I felt like I was on like a magic carpet, but I really could see her singing something in like a Disney movie or something like that when something magical is happening, because that's
read the Muppets or something, right?
Oh, that's right, you did say that.
Something about the Muppets, but her being on a Muppet show is wild.
Yeah,
we had to go back to the Wiki. Nightmare Revisited and Muppets the Green Album from Walt Disney Records.
Makes sense. That makes perfect sense, man, because you really have to be able to hit octaves and hit those notes that most people can't hit to bring scenes alive, especially when Disney does their animated movies and it's like a really powerful, important part, you know, the music really brings that scene to life. It brings it to another level. So I can see that she would be perfect for something like
real
that.
Real quick, Ryan, we mentioned, I don't know when we're going to release what video, but in one video that we've done, we mentioned mezzo-soprano. And I was like, I don't know.
But one of the best songs I've heard in my life, man. Seriously.
One of the greatest, great song for me. One of the greatest performances on a song I've ever heard, man. Yeah, that really made an impression clearly on both of us.
Yeah,
man.
Dude. Crazy.
Shout out to
Amy Lee, to Evanescence.
Amy Lee and Evanescence. And we definitely want to make sure we give shine to the group.
Yep.
Those guitars in this, how powerful they were.
Yep.
Were also really well, and it complimented her really well, man. Yeah, so that to me,
that
boy,
was great. That was
women
great.
Women who rock, bro, you can't front on that.
Yeah.
Even if it's not your taste, she rocks.
I'm telling you.
Give us some more from Evanescence. You know we're getting back. Anytime, y'all can tell.
Yeah,
anytime a band makes an impact like it's made on us in this video, we're going to get back to them.
Absolutely.
Maybe soon. So give us some suggestions for Evanescence in the comments. And that's it, guys. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. The link for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.